We seat comfortably. Let's start with a few deep breaths. Okay. Make yourself very comfortable. Maybe you can sit in cross-legged, maybe in pose of adapt. Okay, or something different like lotus, half lotus, or even stretching legs to the front. That's also good. And sit on support. I'm sitting on the block, maybe sit on a couple of blocks if you need a folded blanket. Check that your knees lower than the hips. Okay, and then make adjustments. Flatten the buttocks, lengthen through the whole spine, take your shoulders back, relax your hands, somewhere on your thighs, thumb and finger connected. Close your eyes, notice your whole body, your whole posture, make adjustments, any adjustments you need. Deepen your breath, take a few deep breaths, lengthening on the inhalation, see if you can lengthen more. And as you exhale, just engage your tummy muscles or your core muscles and keep the back straight. And again, inhale, lengthening. Exhale, engaging the core muscles and so on. Deep, comfortable breath. Try to use whole capacity of your lungs. Keep your breath deep and flowing. And remind yourself about your intention. We all have intentions. Your intention can be very small or very big. Your intention can be just for this yoga class or for a day, for a few days ahead. And if you are in doubt, ask yourself, how are you committed to yourself? How are you committed to your health? And find the inspiration in your answer. And keep your breath deep, flowing, enjoyable through the rest of the practice. Take another deep breath before you open your eyes. And when you're ready, then open your eyes, relax your arms, relax your legs, move the block to the side and come and sit into your child pose. So we start with the child pose. So come and sit like so with your feet flat, big toes touching, knees are wider to the sides, wider than the hips. And you just sit back, heels, towards to your heels, hips moving back to your heels, stretch your arms, rest your forehead on the floor, or maybe bring your hands beneath your forehead if you need more space, or even make fists if you need more space. And relax here for a moment. Observe the breath. The breath is deep and flowing. The hips moving back, closer to the heels. Deep breath. And maybe move your hands a little bit more forward. Give yourself more length and stretch. This is passive stretch. Passive, gentle stretch. The child pose. Soften. Take another deep breath. Just noticing how you feel in your body, in your back. And then inhale, lift your head and come on your all fours. Okay, turn your toes under and little cat and the cow stretch. So once again, lengthen, moving your arms forward and your hips back, lengthen through the sides. Then soften, melt the back of the heart. Inhale and look up, lift your tailbone. And as you exhale round, tailbone between the sitting bones, exhale fully. Inhale, abdomen down, lift your heart, look up. And again, exhale and round. This is your cat stretch. And then the cow stretch. And again, the cat stretch, rounding. Let's do it again, once more. Inhale, look up. Exhale and turn around. Well done. And then bring your back parallel to the floor in neutral position. Let's step back with the knees or move your hands forward where you have more space on your yoga mat and come up to down facing dog. With your knees bent, I want you to lengthen through your spine, lengthen, lengthen, squeeze your arms, support your posture with strong shoulders, strong arms, and lift your tummy muscles and push the hips as high as you can up towards the ceiling. Let's lengthen through the spine first. Engage your tummy muscles more and then spot walk a few times, bend your right knee, then the left. Okay, we try to stretch one leg at a time. So straighten one leg, then another leg. And you keep moving the hips up, up towards the ceiling. Well done. And then come up high on your tiptoes. Bend your knees again forward and lengthen again through your spine. Engage your core muscles to support your lower back and maybe straighten your legs completely, maybe not. Don't worry, you don't have to straighten the legs. You can keep your knees bent absolutely fine. On your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees, and bring your knees back on the floor. So you're again on your all fours. Okay, bend your elbows back and lie down on your tummy. Point your toes back, and then come up to baby raised cobra, just a small cobra. Don't come up very high. Lengthen the tailbone and just come up halfway. Halfway to raised cobra, soften your buttocks, soften, soften, soften. Shoulders away from your ears, do the double chin, look straight. Inhale, and as you exhale, drag your hands back and stretch forward. Keep lengthening, lengthening away from the hips. Well done, and again, toes under, come on your all fours, and then again to down facing dog. Lift your hips high and stretch. Lengthen through the spine, through the legs. On your next inhale, come up high on your tiptoes. Look at your hands, bend your knees, and walk towards your hands into your forward bend. Make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider. Just check with your lower back. If you feel very tight in your back or the hips, you just take your feet wider. Squeeze the legs, bend your knees if you need. Checking the back of the pelvis, tipping forward. We're going to do five extensions, half forward bend. Inhale, extend forward, hold the legs or hold the floor, and it's okay to have your knees bent, stretch, and then exhale, tummy in, strong legs, squeeze the legs, and bam, bend your knees if you need. And again, inhale, extend forward, half forward bend, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your legs, and again, bam, knees bent, okay, absolutely fine if you need. And again, inhale, stretch, exhale, tummy engaged, strong legs and bar. We do twice more. Again, inhale, lengthen. Stretch forward, hold the legs on the floor. Exhale and bar. We do once more. Again, inhale and stretch. Strong legs, squeeze the legs. Exhale, bar. Well done. Now, I suggest bend your knees forward, hold the hips, lift your elbows and your shoulders so you can straighten your back. Lift your chin and come up with a straight back, knees bent. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your legs, come up, and then exhale and relax your arms. And just roll your shoulders, soften, loosen up. Okay, well done. So as we're going to practice lots of different twists today, I want to remind you this lengthening the tailbone action, how it looks if you look at my hips. So we're going to do that a lot before moving into the twist. We're going to create lots of length through the spine. And little movement, like lengthening the tailbone, will help you to create more length. So this is like that. Again, watch my hips, the tailbone, lengthening. So I'm moving my tailbone downwards to elongate my lower back, especially the lower back, okay? Without moving the hips forward. So this is again, lengthening the tailbone. And you've probably noticed that your tummy muscles engage. So this is a good thing. So when you're lengthening the tailbone, your tummy muscles get stronger, engage towards the midline. And this is good to support your lower back before moving into the twist. Yeah, we're going to remember that. Okay, come to the front of your mat and we do the sequence. We're going to add lots of different twists. Remind you again, listen to your body. You don't have to do everything. Okay, make space between your feet. Hips width apart or wider if you feel very tight in your hips. Take your hands to your heart. Inhale, lift your sternum. Exhale, relax your arms. Inhale, very gentle back bend or just straighten upwards. And as you exhale, forward bend, bend your knees if you need. Inhale on your finger pads and stretch forward, half forward bend. Exhale, squeeze the legs and bow. Move your hands by the side of your heels. Step back with your right foot back. High leg lunge or lower leg lunge, whatever is suitable for you. Squeeze the legs, lengthen the tailbone and lift your chest. Deep breath. Exhale, stepping back into the plank or half plank. Take a moment, choose your option, plank or half plank. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders, tummy muscles lifted. Look straight. Inhale, and as you exhale, lean forward, knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows back and lie down on your tummy. Point your toes back, and we come up to raise cobra again, halfway, just halfway. Lengthening the tailbone, come up halfway, keep the length, move your shoulders lower, double chin, look straight. Drag your hands back, and especially when you go down, keep dragging your hands back and keep lengthening away from the hips, lengthen. Lengthen, lengthen. Shoulders lifted, toes under, come up to down facing dog or come on your all fours if you need, and then down facing dog. Take a deep breath there. And we're going to spot walk. As you're going to spot walk, move the hips from side to side. So this is a little gentle twist. So a little gentle twist, moving the hips from side to side. So we start to move gently. Okay, from side to side. One leg at a time, bend one knee, then another knee. Checking how you feel in your lower back and the hips. You don't have to do big movements. You can do just small little movements. And then come up on your tiptoes. Look between your hands. Bring your knees down to the floor and step forward with your right foot. Right foot outside of your right hand. And this is where you're placing padding for sensitive knee. If your left knee is sensitive, place blanket under your knee. Okay, squeeze the legs, come up with your hands on your front knee. You're going to come up to Anjaneyasana or the half moon pose, crescent moon pose. Lengthen the tailbone, tummy in, and then stretch your arms. Take a deep breath, front hip moving forward, breathing deeply into your chest, extend away from the hips. Exhale, and you touch the floor. Stepping back to down facing dog, and then we change side. Down facing dog, deep breath. And then come up on your tiptoes. Left leg up, step forward, left foot forward. Outside of your left hand, or knees down, and then left foot forward. Squeeze the legs, come up with your hands on your front knee. Lengthening the tailbone, tummy muscles engaged, and stretch. Crescent moon pose, deep breath into your chest. Well done, and then exhale, squeeze the legs, touch the floor. Step back again to down facing dog, take a deep breath. We're going to change legs again. Inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look at your hands, right leg up, step forward, or knees down, and then right foot forward. Take a moment, squeeze the legs, come up with your hands on your front knee. Again, remember that action, lengthening the tailbone, tummy muscles engaged. Stretch your arms upwards and then bend your elbows to the sides. We call it palms arms. And let's again lengthen more. Lift your chest, squeeze your shoulders at the back, and we're going to look to the right. So join into the right, gentle twist. Then come back to the middle. Again, lengthen, use your arms, create more length. Engage your tummy muscles, look to the left. Okay, join into the left gently and then come back. Stretch your arms and touch the floor. Stepping back, down facing dog, stretch. And think about changing legs. Come up on your tiptoes, look at your hands. Left leg up, step forward or knees down, and then left foot forward. Come up with your hands on your front knee, lengthening the tailbone, tummy in. Stretch your arms, bend your elbows to the sides. Again, lots of inhale and lengthening. Looking to the left. Okay, gentle stretch. Come back to the middle. Lengthen. Exhale, looking to the right. Started to twist more. Come back to the middle. Stretch your arms. Touch the floor. Step back to down facing dog. Take a deep breath in. Stretch and lengthen through the sides, through the whole spine, through the back of the body. And then come up on your tiptoes, bend your knees and walk towards your hands into your forward bend. Make space between your feet, hips width apart or widen. Squeeze the legs, bend your knees if you need. And come up, inhale, come up and stretch, salute into the sun. Exhale, hands to your heart. Deep breath in. Exhale, relax your arms. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, forward bend. Bend your knees if you need. Take it easy. Inhale on your finger pads and stretch forward. Exhale and bow. Hands by the side of your heels. Left foot back. High leg lunge or lower leg lunge. Lengthening in the tailbone. Tummy engaged. Look straight. We're going to the twist. Keep your left hand down beneath your left shoulder. Go on your finger pads if you can. And stretch your right arm up. Look up, shoulders moving back, lift your chest and stretch away from the hips. Keep the length. Deep breath in. And then exhale, look down, touch the floor. Stepping back to down facing dog. Take a deep breath there. And then come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands, changing legs, left leg up. And step forward, big step forward, all knees down, and then left foot forward. Squeeze the legs. Let's just check the space between your feet, hips width apart. Lengthen in the tailbone, tummy lifted. Left arm, look up, or just look to the side. Comfortably with your neck. Keep the length and deep breath into your chest. Inhale. And as you exhale, look down, touch the floor. Step back into the plank or half plank. What is suitable for your half plank? With the knees down if you need. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders. Lengthening the tailbone to your heels, tummy lifted. Inhale. And as you exhale, lean forward, knees, elbows, or bend your elbows. Point your toes back. Come up to wrist cobra slow, listening to your lower back. Lengthening the tailbone, press your whole legs into the floor. Shoulders down, double chin. This time, maybe lift your chin just a little. Inhale. And as you exhale, with the shoulder blades, carry your heart forward, stretch, stretch, stretch. Shoulders lifted. Toes under, come on your all fours. Come on your all fours. And with the cat and the cow, stretch. Inhale, look up. Exhale, round. Lovely stretch through the back. Gentle. Inhale, look up. The cow stretch, and then a cat stretch, and we do once more. Again, inhale, look up, and then exhale, relax. Relax your back, bend your elbows back like so, and lie down on your tummy again. So bend your elbows back, lie down on your tummy, and now I want you to take your hands outside of your mat or on the floor. The floor, the carpet where you practice, just outside of your mat. I'm going to move slightly to the side. Okay, on your finger pads. So we have Spider-Man hands, lengthening the tailbone, and come up again to raise cobra on your finger pads. You don't have to come up very high. Move your shoulders away from your ears. Double chin, lift your chin a little. Keep the length, keep lengthening forward, ground your whole legs. Make sure that your lower back is happy. You don't have to come up very high. Inhale, and as you exhale, with the shoulder blades, carry your heart forward, stretch, 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 forward. Shoulders lifted, hands by the side of your chest, down facing dog. Toes under, down facing dog, or come on your all fours, and then down facing dog. Take a deep breath there. Stretch through the whole back of the body. And then come up on your tiptoes, bring your knees down to the floor. Look at the screen for a moment. So I want you to show you this little twist from down facing dog. If it's okay with you, if it's all right with your back. So we're going to try this. Going to try to keep moving this way. One way, straighten, and then you're going to go to the other way, and again straighten. So we try to do this a few times, a little bit of twisting, if it's okay with you. Okay, come on your all fours. And then to down facing dog. And lift your hips high. Let's check the shoulders. Squeeze your shoulders, squeeze your arms. Tummy muscles engage, bend your knees forward. And let's start twisting. Twisting to one side. We try to keep space between the knees. Hips width apart and to the other side. If it's okay, just have fun. Just moving to one side. Be creative to the other side. You might not look like what I do, but just try and do a little twist. One side, then another side. Okay, and then come back. Make sure you do the same amount of times on each side. Come back to down facing dog. Come up on your tiptoes and then bring your knees down to the floor. Look at your hands. Step forward with your right foot outside of your right hand. Squeeze the legs. So we're going into the other twist. Come up with your hands on your front knee. And one option, placing left elbow to your right knee, look to the side. Okay, maybe you can hook your elbow over the knee and bring your hands together in prayer position. And you're taking the shoulders back. Lots of tailbone here, tummy muscles lifted. So choose your variation. Take a deep breath. Inhale. And then exhale, look down, touch the floor. Stepping back to down facing dog. Straighten, stretch through the spine. Check that you're not standing on your wrists. Use your whole hands, all finger pads pressing into the floor, not the wrists. And then changing legs on your tiptoes, left leg up. Step forward, all knees down, and then left foot forward. Right knee down on the floor. Engage your core muscles. Come up with your hands to your front knee. Again, taking deep breath to lengthen. Tailbone, tummy muscles in. Right elbow to your left knee, look to the side. Or maybe hook your elbow over the knee and bring your hands together. And again, check your hips, squeeze the hips, tummy lifted. Look to the side, twist. How's your core muscles? Still engaged, supporting the lower back. Deep breath in. And then exhale. Look down, touch the floor. Down facing dog. Let's step back, take a deep breath. And then come up on your tiptoes. Look between your hands, plank or half plank. Choose your option. What is your variation? Squeeze your shoulders at the back. Tummy muscles lifted. Again, that action of lengthening the tailbone. Very useful here. Inhale. And as you exhale, lengthen, lean forward, knees, elbows, or just your elbows. Point your toes back. And again, take your hands on the floor outside of your yoga mat. So, and watch me for a moment. Of course, if you can see the screen. So we try to do a little twist. We come up halfway to raised cobra. And then we take one foot closer to the opposite hand. And then come back and we change side. Okay, let's do it together. Okay, come up halfway, lengthening the tailbone, come up to raised cobra. Just make sure that you're comfortable. You can stop here or take your right foot towards your left hand as close as possible. So this is a little twist to the side, deep breath, and then come back. Take a moment. Again, lengthening the tailbone. And taking now left foot to your right hand. It doesn't matter how far you go. You might feel a little bit different on this side. Okay. I just touched my singing bowl. Deep breath. And then come back. Come back. And again, lengthen. Exhale, release. Hands by the side of your chest. Come on your all fours. Into the cat and the cow stretch. Toes under. Let's do cow stretch. Look up. Tailbone lifted. The cat stretch. And again, inhale. The cow stretch. Exhale. The cat stretch. And then come up to down facing dog. Have a good stretch through the spine, through the back of the legs. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, and look between your hands and walk towards your hands into your forward bend. Make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider, squeeze the legs, Bend your knees if you need before you come up standing. And then come up standing with a super strong leg. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your legs. Stretch your arms, salute into the sun. Exhale, hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. Relax your arms and have a little break. Have a drink of water or whatever you drink today. Okay, the next posture. Watch me please, we will need two blocks. So blocks or bricks are very, very useful for the next posture. So we're going to do this posture, nose to knee pose first, and then we try to twist from this posture. Okay, it looks like that. We're going to step back with one foot. Okay, the blocks will go by the side, like so. And before you go into this posture, you're going to straighten the hips. Inhale, you're lengthening. Engaging the hips towards the midline, so you're going to keep the legs strongly joining, hips strongly joining. So you know that your lower back and hips very happy here in a good alignment. Inhale, and as you exhale, you're going to fold forward, then holding the blocks or the bricks. You're going to lengthen, again, keeping this length, softening between the shoulder blades, and maybe you bow a little bit more. So we stay here for 5 breaths on one side, then we're going to change side, and then we go into the twist. So the twist looks like that. You're going to lift one hand beneath your block. I'm going to just move one block to the side so you can see. So this is one option, another option for the twist, even stretching the arm, or maybe moving your hand on the floor. Okay, and maybe for more advanced postures, moving hand closer and or maybe even behind. So this is where you can play these different options. And then bend your knee, come back and change inside. Okay, so that was a very quick demonstration. So let's do it together now. So grab the blocks. It's very useful, especially in the beginning of this posture, to use the blocks or the bricks. Okay, step back with your right foot back. Okay, and then check space between your feet. Hips width apart, let's just check that space. This is good space for the hips in the lower back. Hips facing forward to the front of your mat. Hands on the hips, inhale. Lengthen again, remember that action? Lengthening the tailbone, tummy muscles engaged. Keep the side body long with the strong, super strong hips and your legs holding forward. With the left hand, you can encourage to move the left hip back. Then look down, hands down on the blocks, bricks. So make sure that you're comfortable. Inhale, lengthening. Keep moving the hips back, groins back. Exhale, soften between your shoulder blades. Start to bow over your front leg. And again, inhale, lengthen. Stretch forward, squeeze the legs. Engage your core muscles and bow. And so on. 5 breaths here. And if you don't need blocks, you can easily hold the floor. Maybe this is you. And again, inhale, lengthening. Exhale, tummy muscles engaged, bow. Relax your neck. We try to keep neck in line with the spine. Exhale, bow. Let's do it once more. Inhale, you lengthen, push the hips back. Exhale, tummy muscles engaged, and you bow over your front leg. Well done. Now bend your front knee, step forward. You are in a forward bend, either holding blocks or no blocks. Okay, now hold the hips, lift your elbows, shoulders, lift your chin, bend your knees if you need, and come up gently with your back straight. Change inside, now stepping back with the left. Okay, blocks or no blocks. Okay, left foot back. Again, checking space between your feet. Hips width apart. Let's just make that space, very good space for the hips in the back. Hips facing forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, draw the legs towards the midline. And then folding forward. Now with your right hand, you're encouraging your right hip to move back. Okay, the hips level, hips still level. You can take hands at the back and check. Drop your hands down. 5 breaths. Inhale, lengthening, pushing the hips back, lengthen through the sides. Exhale, soften between your shoulder blades. How's your neck? Neck is soft. And again, inhale, extend. Exhale, still drawing the legs towards the midline and the hips, fold. And so on. Take your time. Using blocks is quite good, it gives you more space. Okay, listening to your body. Play with different variations, with different options. Lengthening on the inhale, folding on the exhale. Well done, let's do once more. Squeeze the legs as you exhale and bow. Brilliant. And when you finish, bend your front knee, step forward into your forward bend. Before you come up, again, lots of energy on the legs. Take your hands to the hips, elbows, shoulders. Lift your chin, come up with a straight back. Inhale. Well done. And then relax your arms. Great. Now we're going to do all the same, but we're going to add twist into this posture. Okay, stepping back with the right foot back. And again, grab the blocks if you need. Oh, for the twist, you probably will need just one block for one hand because you're going to stretch the other arm upwards. Okay, one block right for your right hand. Okay, inhale and lengthen. Exhale, folding again with the left hand, encourage your left hip to move back. Now bring your right hand down beneath your right shoulder, maybe the block, maybe the floor. Okay, lengthening. How's your tummy muscles? Lift your tummy muscles up, looking to the left. Look to the left and just take a moment here. Again, elongate your back. What I do here with my right, that's left, with my left hand, I move the hips more back and lengthen. And then stretch my left arm up. And then maybe look up or just to the side. Make sure that your neck is comfortable, whatever you do. Deep breath. Again, lift your tummy muscles to have good support for your back and open into your twist. Okay, choose your option. Maybe your hand on the floor, or maybe you're moving your right hand closer to the left foot. And again, checking with your back, lengthening the tailbone, extending away from the hips. Breathe. Press your feet into the floor stronger, strong feet. Extend, stretch. Well done. Inhale. And as you exhale, look down, bend your front knee, touch the floor, and you're going to step back to down facing dog. Have a good stretch there. Lengthen, realign the spine, press all finger pads into the floor stronger. Stretch and extend. Through the whole back of the body, back of the legs. On your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands, walk towards your hands. Come up gently from the forward bend, bend your knees again forward if you need. Hold your hips, lift your elbows, shoulders, lift your chin, come up. Inhale. Changing side now, stepping back with the right foot back. Oh, left foot back, changing side, left foot back. Okay, make space between your feet. Hips width apart, inhale and extend. And as you exhale, folding forward with the right hand again, encouraging your right hip to move back and lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Look down, now your left hand goes down beneath your shoulder, block, bricks, or whatever you need there. Again, encouraging your tailbone between the sitting bones, tummy muscles lifted, look to the right. Maybe this is just enough. Don't worry to do everything. Oh, maybe stretching your right arm up. Look into the side or look up at your right hand. Okay, play with different options. Lengthening through the sides of the body. With the right hand, maybe encourage your right hip to move back a little bit more. Engaging your core muscles. Playing with different options. Maybe moving your hand closer or the block closer to your front foot. Breathe. Squeeze the hips, press your feet into the floor and extend. Keeping the length. Keep your legs steady. Breathing deeply into your chest. Playing with different variations. Press your feet into the floor stronger. Take another deep breath. And then exhale, look down. Bend your front knee, touch the floor, step back to down facing dog. Down facing dog, good stretch. Hips lifting high, engaging all your core muscles to support your back. Extend your legs back, heels down towards the floor. On your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, knees down, and sit into the child pose, please. Take your knees wide. Big toes touching, let's sit back. Closer to the heels. Stretch your arms forward. Forehead is on the floor, or on your hands, or on your fists if you need it again. Hips moving back, closer to the heels. Your hands moving forward. Give yourself more length. And relax there. Observe how you feel. How you feel in your lower back, your hips, your whole back, the shoulders. On your next inhale, lift your hand. Slide your hands closer to your knees. Okay, well done. And please be seated with your legs in front. So we're going to do the forward bend. So, and we stretch legs in front, and then we're going to move legs very, very wide apart. So taking your legs wide apart, okay. Take your hands back and lean back. So, and then observe your legs. Press your legs into the floor, your heels pressing into the floor. Maybe make this adjustment, make your hamstrings a little wider and you press your hamstrings into the floor, back of the thighs. You definitely want to feel back of the thighs on the floor. And then let's check the back. Take one hand at the lower back and check. The back is straight or maybe even curvy, but not rounded. Let's just check with one hand, back is straight. Lean more back if you need, if your back is not straight. And then again, remembering these actions, little bit of tailbone, engaging the tummy muscles, creating the length, and folding forward, folding forward. Press your hands into the floor behind. Keep the back tall, long. Again, checking with your hand that your back is straight, not rounded. Keeping the back straight all the time. Pressing the legs into the floor, strong legs, and lengthening and stretching forward. Okay, press your heels down, back of the thighs. This is your hamstring, back of the thighs. You feel them on the floor flat. And if you want to check the energy on the legs, if you touch the front thigh muscles, these muscles are very hard, they intense, working. And again, inhale, lengthen, exhale, tummy in, and stretching forward. It doesn't matter how far you go. Press your legs down, press, extend and lengthen. Well done. Deep breath. And if you're quite low and you want to hold the floor in front, please do. And again, use your arms to lengthen through the sides and then soften between your shoulder blades, relax your neck, maybe go a little deeper into your forward bend, but remember you don't have to do everything. If you feel you need to lean back more to protect your lower back, that's absolutely fine. Listen to your back. The forward bend comes from the hips, not from rounding the back. We keep the back straight. If you're quite low, you might want to try this finger pads on the floor. Lift your elbows, lengthen, lengthen, soften between your shoulder blades. Relax your neck. Again, respect the resistance. Hamstrings have a very good stretch here, very intense stretch, so please don't work over pain. Have a good stretch. Great, and then inhale and come back. Okay, now time to relax the legs first, relax, relax. And then with your hands, help your legs to bring them closer and give them a little shake. Let's just shake the legs. Shake, shake, shake. Okay, well done. And we do seated twist. So bend your right leg. Take your right foot outside of the left leg, hug your knee, and sit straight, and then check your back. How's your back doing? Sitting upright, tall? If not, if your back a bit rounded, grab the block And you can sit on the block. I'll show you. Sit on the block. So definitely want your back to be upright. You want the pelvis tip forward a little. Okay, so this is good. And if it's appropriate, you take your left foot to the right hip. Okay, if it's okay. And again, back straight, upright. And if your left knee is not happy, you stretch your right leg again to the front. So this is another option. That's absolutely fine to have one leg straight. Okay, I'm going to move the block to the side because I'm quite happy to sit on the floor. Okay, and let's hug the front knee. Inhale and lengthen. Exhale, moving into the twist. Finger pads behind you, closer to your sacrum. So you can use this hand, press into the floor and again extend. Exhale, tummy muscles in, moving deeper into the twist. On your next inhale, if it's okay, left arm up. See if you can hook your elbow over the knee. And again, inhale, extend and stretch. Exhale, tummy muscles engaged, moving deeper into the twist. And maybe you have space for your right hand to walk around the hips, moving deeper. Check your neck is comfortable, chin lifted, like drinking champagne, back of the head back. Let's take another deep breath. Expand your chest, lift your sternum, and move deeper. Great. And then come back. Come back to the middle. Hug your front knee, sit straight, shoulders back, your ears back, crown of the head, reaching upwards. We change sides. If you have both legs crossed, look at your top leg. Lift your hips and go 360 degrees all the way around and sit again on the floor. This is your left leg now on top. Okay. Or change your legs. So you just bend your left, take your left foot outside of your right, and maybe bring your right foot closer to the left hip. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, engaging the core muscles, moving into the twist. It doesn't matter how far, just check if this side might feel a little bit different. I definitely feel the difference on this side. And that's okay. Right arm up, lengthen. See if you can hook your elbow. And again, inhale, you stretch. Exhale, tummy in, moving deeper into the twist. Breath by breath. Remembering to lengthen first, take a deep inhale. Lengthen, exhale, engaging the core muscles, moving gently. Again, listening to your body, respect the resistance, and practice lovingly to our body. And the twists are amazing to create more space between vertebrae, to relieve and release tightness or tiredness on the back, and we're giving a lovely massage to all the internal organs. Great. And then come back. Come back, hug your front knee. And again, sit tall, shoulders up and back, your ears back, crown of the head, reaching upwards. Okay, it would be very nice now, again, to realign the spine. Okay, we're going to, watch me for a second, we're going to come up on the feet this time and take very good stretch. Hips moving back and you're going to lengthen this way and you have a lot of stretch for the hips. As the legs wide apart, you have lots of space to stretch here. Okay, and when you come up, back straight, sliding your hands up the legs. So let's come up on your feet. Take your feet very wide and you check your feet parallel. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, squeeze the legs, pinch your hips back and fold. Okay, folding, moving your hands forward as far as you can. If you need to grab the block, that's absolutely fine. Hold the block and you walk the block forward and lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Then the whole weight of the body moving back, your feet and your shins squeezing in, inner thighs moving back, lovely stretch for the lower back here, lovely stretch for your inner hamstrings, for the hips, for the whole back. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Easy breathing. Relax your neck. The gravity is helping us here to stretch the back, to relax the neck. Another deep breath. And then move your hands beneath your face first. Again, re-engage your legs towards the midline. Hold your shins with your hands and slide your hands up your legs. Well done. And then zigzag your feet together. Zigzag, zigzag, zigzag. Okay, lovely. And please be seated and watch me. So if you would like to try this lovely stretch, if it's okay with your back, just make sure that your back is clear for that. If you want to bring the block under the hips, and or maybe even two blocks, go a little higher if it's okay, and you're going to relax like so in your shavasana. So if you feel this is appropriate, or instead of the block, you can fold the blanket and give yourself a little gentle body bend here. Okay, so please do try. Okay, and if it's not appropriate, you just lie down into your shavasana without block, without blanket, like so. Okay, so if you would like to try, I'll do it with you. So if you want to take a block or maybe even the brick, if your lower back is clear, you're placing under the hips. Okay, and you're stretching your legs and just relax here. So this is gentle back bend and lovely openness for the front of the hips. If it's appropriate, always listening to the body, adjusting, okay, adjusting to your practice. And maybe this is appropriate. If not, lie down in your shavasana. So you take your feet wider than the hips and you relax there on the floor without block, without blanket. Okay. Just checking with your body, is that okay? To stay on the block, maybe it is. Let's focus on the breath. Let's just relax here with the deep breath. Breath is deep and flowing, especially your exhalations, long, soften. With each exhalation, relaxing a little bit deeper into your grounding points where your body touching the floor. Exhale and soften. Exhale and let go of all the unnecessary tension. With each breath, becoming softer and more relaxed. And if you're still on the block, now I want you to bend your knees. Lift your hips, move the block to the side and relax in your shavasana, just relaxing on the floor. And again, straighten your legs, relax and soften. And again, observe all the sensations in your body, the physical sensations, the flow of the breath, noticing the flow of your thoughts, just checking in with yourself. What it's like to be you right now. Relaxing, softening into the steady support beneath you. Now, as your relaxation comes to the end, bring your awareness back to your surroundings, back to the room you are in, to all the sounds around you. Deepen your breath, continue to deepen your breathing. Then wiggle your toes, your fingers, slide your legs together. Arms by the side of your body and stretch. Take your arms over your head. Lengthen, stretch the stretch away from the waistline. And then bend your knees to your chest. Hug your knees, gently rock from side to side. Reawakening the lower back. Let's do this a few times, it's quite nice. Little massage for the lower back. And then roll over to your right hand side. Come up to the sitting. Find again the block and sit on it. And with your hands in Ajna Mudra, we're going to close the class. Inhale, lift and lengthen. And then slightly lean back, just to feel strong support of your back muscles. Support steadiness of the universe. Reflect your practice, reflect your intention of the practice. Notice how you feel. Enjoy extra strength, flexibility, and clarity of mind. And we finish class with one gentle om. Exhale first. Inhale. Om. Bow your head to your heart, to the light within you, and open your eyes. Well done, everyone. Thank you very much. Namaste. And have a lovely day.